Is UKIP a political force that has run its course? Like the abolitionists, the Chartists, the Anti-Corn Law League, and the suffragettes. All of them faded away when their principal aims had been secured. Indeed, it's hard to read last night's results in any other way. Just months after the party secured its single-minded objective, an almost complete wipeout. All the seats it was defending lost, a single council seat gained.
It was disappointing that I didn't get back in, but, UKIP, unfortunately, people are voting Conservative or Labour because they think Brexit's finished.
So has the music stopped for UKIP? This is Boston in Lincolnshire, the most Brexit-supporting part of the UK. The county started the night with 13 UKIP councillors, but not one dodged the drop. UKIP voters, it seems, part of a stampede to the Conservatives.
From being 18, I always voted Labour, and my family was all Labour. I've never, ever voted for Tories, but we started voting for UKIP, and now they've sort of done their job, so I like what the Tory party has to say much better than Labour now. So it'll be Tory for me from now on.
I like what Farage used to say, but I think, like I say, their job's done now. So, and I like Theresa May now. I think she's about the only one who's talking much sense and you can believe in what she's saying.
Membership of the European Union has been a disaster for us. We all know this.
UKIP was founded by academic Dr. Alan Sked as a pushback against European federalism. Popular support grew from its campaign to stop Britain joining the euro, still remembered in its badge. But it only really took off after the huge wave of Eastern European immigration hit the UK after 2004. UKIP's big electoral breakthrough came in 2009. They came second in that year's European elections, and their estimated vote share in the council elections held on the same day was 9%. Fast forward to 2013. And UKIP turned in its best domestic performance with 23% of the vote. They slipped a bit the following year, but came first in the European Parliament elections. In the general election of 2015, they got 13% and 3.8 million votes. But yesterday, post the Brexit referendum, their projected vote share has plummeted to just 5%.
I think it's over for UKIP. Job done. We were instrumental in making sure we got the referendum. We played a part in making sure we won the referendum. Now what we need to do is make sure that May has a mega mandate on June the 8th to make sure that she gets on with it.
So might the party that Nigel Farage helped found now go the same way as the anti-slavery movement commemorated in this Westminster memorial?
If, in 2 years' time, we haven't got back our territorial fishing waters, immigration is not under control, we're still paying billions of pounds every year to the European Club, then having raised people's expectations to this level and having not delivered, you could see a UKIP stronger than it's ever been.
UKIP's current leader, Paul Nuttall, has declined all requests for interviews today, but in a statement said the party had been the victim of its own success. It's hard to believe that in two decades, UKIP went from this to altering the course of the nation's history. Few would argue that we would have had the EU referendum without it. And yet, there is no gratitude in politics. And if UKIP want an encore, it will have to continually renew its relevance.